Dear students, welcome once again to my session. I am Dr. V. Ramachandra Murthy, Professor of Mathematics, RR Institute of Technology, Bangalore. The next part of your syllabus is applications of ordinary differential equations. Three applications have been prescribed in your syllabus. Namely, orthogonal trajectories, Newton's law of cooling, and LR circuits. So to begin with, let me consider one of the applications, orthogonal trajectories. So let me define what is orthogonal trajectories. So first application is orthogonal trajectories. Orthogonal trajectories. So it is defined like this. Two families of curves such that every member of either family cuts each member of the other family at right angles are called orthogonal trajectories of each other. So let me write down the definition. Two family of curves. Two families of curves such that every member of either family cuts each member of the other family, each member of the other family, each member of the other family of curves at right angles. At right angles. At right angles are called orthogonal trajectories. Orthogonal trajectories of each other. Of each other. Of each other. So it is like this. In XY plane, let me consider. You have a family of curves. Say C1, family of curves C1. Then, if you can find another family of curves such that every member cuts every member of the other family, let us say C2, at right angles, then the two family of curves C1 and C2 are orthogonal trajectories of each other. Some of the classical examples are a world globe, meridians and parallels are orthogonal trajectories of each other. So classical examples are the following. Are a world globe, world globe meridian and parallels are orthogonal trajectories of each other are orthogonal trajectories. In an electric field, the path along which the current flows, are orthogonal trajectories. The equipotential curves for a constant voltage. So electric field, the path along which the current flows, are orthogonal trajectories of equipotential curves when the voltage is constant. Then third example, in fluid flow, the streamlines. Lines of constant velocity potential, that is lines of constant potential, velocity potential, constant velocity potential, constant velocity potential. Constant velocity potential are orthogonal trajectories. Isothermal curves are orthogonal trajectories of each other. So these are the commonly occurring classical examples of orthogonal trajectories. Now there are, now let us try to determine for a given family of curves how to find the orthogonal trajectories. There are two types. One is finding orthogonal trajectories of a family, given family of curves in Cartesian form, and finding orthogonal trajectories of a given family of curves in polar form. Now let me consider first the orthogonal trajectories of a family of curves in Cartesian form. So firstly, let us consider the case where we find orthogonal trajectories of a given family of curves in Cartesian form. Let me take this as one. To find, let me give the procedure of finding the orthogonal trajectories for a Cartesian family of curves. A family of curves given in Cartesian form. To find the orthogonal trajectories, orthogonal trajectories, orthogonal trajectories of the family of curves, family of curves f of x comma y comma c equal to 0. That is Cartesian form. This is Cartesian form. Cartesian form. Where C is the parameter or arbitrary constant. So this is the working procedure. Working method or procedure. Procedure. As a step one, we try to formulate the differential equation, ordinary differential equation, by eliminating the arbitrary constant or the parameter. The first step, for its, that means this family of curves, f of x comma y comma 0, c comma equal to 0, f of x comma y comma c equal to 0. For its differential equation, for its differential equation, for its differential equation, in the for f of x comma y comma dy by dx equal to 0. The step two, replace in this differential equation, replace in this differential equation dy by dx by minus dx by dy. Step three, solve solve the differential equation, solve the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories, orthogonal trajectories solve the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories, that is f of x comma y comma minus dx by dy equal to 0. Okay, so let us apply this procedure to find the orthogonal trajectories of the family of curves given in Cartesian form. So let me consider this example, simple example. Find the orthogonal trajectories of the family of curves. Family of curves x into y is equal to 0. So first of all, we should know how to form the differential equation from the given equation between variables and constant, between the variables. So this part has been taught to you already in your pre-university or plus two courses. So this ordinary differential equation is obtained or formed in an attempt to eliminate certain arbitrary constants or parameters from a relation in the variables and constants. So let me write it as a note. Formation of ordinary differential equation. Formation of ordinary differential equation. ODE, so let me write it as ODE. An ordinary differential equation is formed in an attempt to eliminate certain arbitrary constant. It is very important. Certain arbitrary constants. This is also termed as parameters, certain arbitrary constants from a relation in the variables and constants, relation in variables. In the variables and constants. Okay, this has been done in your pre-university course, so let us not spend much time on this and apply this to find the orthogonal trajectories of a given family of curves in Cartesian form as well as in polar form. The solution part. The solution part. The given family of curves is x into y is equal to c. We call this as equation number 1. Now, the arbitrary constant what is present here is c. So, since we are dealing with only ordinary differential equations of first order, we obtain ordinary differential equation of first order by eliminating only one constant. If there are two or more arbitrary constants, so which one to be eliminated will be mentioned in the problem. Otherwise, we will end up with second or third order ordinary differential equation, which is out of scope of your syllabus. Thus, if there is only one, so it need not be mentioned that this one is the arbitrary constant or a parameter to be eliminated to form ordinary differential equation of first order. So, by default, C is the arbitrary constant present here that has to be eliminated to form the differential equation. Now, let me eliminate this C and obtain the required differential equation of the given family of curves. Now, let me differentiate this with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. So then the product of x and y. So I have to apply product rule. X into dy by dx plus y is equal to 0. So by differentiating itself once, that c is eliminated. Okay. So this is the differential equation of the given family of curves, which is the differential equation of 1, which is the differential equation of 1. Differential equation of the given family of curves 1. Okay. Now, this is the first step. In the second step, I have to replace dy by dx by minus dx by dx, dx minus dx by dy in this differential equation. So, call this as call this as 2. Replace dy by dx by minus dx by dy in 2. So therefore, x into minus dx by dy plus y is equal to 0. Or this is minus x dy by dx by dy minus x dx by dy plus y equal to 0 or x into dx by dy minus y equal to 0. Call this as 3. So 3 is the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectory. So 3 3 is the differential equation, differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories to find the family of curves which cuts one orthogonally or other trajectory of one, we have to solve this differential equation 3. So this differential equation 3 can be solved very easily by separating the variables. So 3 can be written as 3 can be written as x into dx by dy is equal to y. Separating the variables, x dx is equal to y dy. We get, separating the variables, we get x dx is equal to y dy. Once the variables separated, its solution is integration of both the sides, each side x dx integral y dy plus some integral constant c. Integration of x with respect to x is x square divided by 2. Integration of y with respect to y is y square divided by 2 plus c. Or this is x square is equal to y square plus 2c, or x square minus y square is equal to 2 into c. So this is the orthogonal trajectories of given family of curves 1. So which is the orthogonal trajectory which is the required, orthogonal trajectories of the given family of curves, So this is how we have to follow the number steps 1, 2, 3 in order to find the orthogonal trajectory of a family of curves given in Cartesian form. So let me consider another example. So let me consider another example. 2. Find the orthogonal trajectory. Find the orthogonal trajectories of family of confocal cones, x square divided by a square plus y square divided by b square plus lambda is equal to 1. where lambda is the parameter. Lambda is the parameter. So here lambda is mentioned as a parameter because there are three constants. So which one is to be eliminated is to be determined, is to be given in the problem. So that is why it is mentioned. You eliminate lambda and then obtain the corresponding differential equation, not by eliminating a square a or b. So when it is specified lambda is the parameter, other two constants need not be considered. Only we have to concentrate on eliminating the lambda. Okay. The solution part. In the solution, a given equation family of curves is x square divided by a square plus y square divided by b square plus lambda is equal to 1. So let me differentiate once, yeah, to eliminate this lambda and to obtain ordinary differential equation of order 1. Of this family of curves. Okay. So differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. Throughout. So 2x divided by a square. Differentiation of y square 2y into dy by dx divided by b square plus lambda is equal to 0. So I can cancel 2 and this can be written as y into dy by dx divided by b square plus lambda is equal to x divided by a square with negative sign. Further, y divided by b square plus lambda, take dy by dx to the left right hand side, is equal to minus x divided by a square into dy by dx. A square by dy by dx. Okay. Now let me multiply by y. So therefore y square divided by b square plus lambda is minus x into y divided by a square into dy by dx. Okay. Okay. Now let me substitute for y square divided by b square plus lambda with this minus x into y by a square into dy by dx, then I will be eliminating lambda and obtaining corresponding first order ordinary differential equation. So substitute in 1, then I get x square divided by a square. Now y square divided by b square plus lambda is minus x into y divided by a square into dy by dx is equal to 1. Now let me multiply by a square throughout, r x square minus x into y divided by dy by dx is equal to a square. Or I can write this as x square minus a square is equal to x into y divided by dy by dx. So again, taking a square to the left hand side and sending this term to the right hand side. R, therefore, x square minus a square into dy by dx is equal to x into y. So call this as equation 2. So this is the differential equation of the given family of curves. So 2 is the differential equation, that is first order ordinary differential equation, differential equation of the given family of curves 1. So in this differential equation, I have to replace dy by dx by minus dx by dy. So replace dy by dx by minus dx by dy in the equation 2. So I will get x square minus a square into minus dx by dy is equal to x into y. Or if you multiply by negative sign, or this can be written as a square minus x square into dx by dy is equal to x into y. Call this as 3. So 3 is nothing but the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories, and we have to solve these 3 to obtain the family of curves which cuts the given family of curves 1 at right angles. Orthogonal trajectories of the family of curves 1. To solve this, which is the 3 is the differential equation of orthogonal trajectories. Solve three. How do we solve 3? By separating the variable, very simple, dx by dy, sorry. This is y. By separating the variables, you can easily separate the variables. A square, separating the variables, a square minus x square, take x to the left hand side, divided by x dx is equal to y into dy. So the variable separated, therefore its solution is integration of each side, integration of a square minus x square divided by x dx is equal to integral y into dy plus some constant c. Now let me simplify. A square divided by x square by x is x with respect to x is equal to y square divided by 2 plus integral constant c. Now let me integrate. A square is constant, a square, dx by x is log x, so a square into log x, a square log x, minus integration of x is x square divided by 2 is equal to y square divided by 2 plus c. Or multiplying throughout by 2, or 2 into a square log x minus x square is equal to y square plus 2c plus 2c. Or this is r x square plus y square is equal to 2a square log x log x x square plus y square is equal to 2a square log x minus 2c minus 2c is the required, which is the solution of the orthogonal trajectories and also represents a family of curves which cuts the given family of curve 1 at right angles. That means this family of curves is the orthogonal trajectory of the given family of curves. So, which is the required orthogonal trajectories of given family of curves 1, which is the required orthogonal trajectory which is the required orthogonal trajectory of the given family of curves Let me consider another problem. Problem 3. Prove that the system of parabolas y square is equal to 4 into a x plus a are self orthogonal. That means they cut themselves at right angles. That means they themselves are orthogonal trajectories of each other. That means I have to show that the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectory is nothing but the differential equation of the given family of curves, that is parabolas, y squared is equal to 4a into x plus a. Now, again, there is only one constant, so need not be mentioned that a is the parameter or arbitrary constant. So, we have to eliminate this a and then obtain the corresponding ordinary differential equation of first order of the given family of curves. The solution for the given family of curves parabolas y squared is equal to 4 into a into x plus a into x plus a. Into x plus a. Now let me eliminate this a by differentiating this once. Differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. So 2y into dy by dx is equal to 4a into 1 plus 0. So this is equal to 2y dy by dx is equal to 4a. So therefore, a is equal to y by 2 into dy by dx. I obtain the value for y, a, and I substitute this a in the given equation 1, given equation family of curves, that is 1, and my a is eliminated, and I obtain the required first order ordinary differential equation of the given family of curves 1. Substitute in 1. Substitute in 1. What happens now? So I get y squared is equal to 4 into a. A is y by 2 into dy by dx into x plus a. Again, this is y by 2 into dy by dx. I substituted for a. Now there is no a here. So this is the differential equation of the given family of curves 1. But let me simplify this first. So I get y square is equal to, now let me multiply, 2 into y into x into dy by dx, 2 into x into y into dy by dx, next 2 into y dy by dx into y by 2, so 2 will get cancelled. I get y square dy by dx into dy by dx, that is whole square, plus I get y square into dy by dx whole square, dy by dx into another dy by dx, so I get dy by dx whole square. So call this as equation number 2. So 2 is the differential equation of the given family of curves 1, which is the differential equation, of given family of curves 1. Now, in this differential equation, I have to replace dy by dx by minus dx by dy. So, replace dy by dx by minus dx by dy in the differential equation of the given family of curves 2. Then I get y square is equal to 2 into x into y minus dx by dy plus y square into minus dx by dy the whole square. So now, if I simplify further, so this is y square is equal to minus 2 into x into y into dx by dy. So minus dx by dy whole square is plus dx by dy whole square. So this is y square into dx by dy whole square. Now, multiply multiply by dy by dx the whole square throughout. Multiply throughout by dy by dx whole square, then I get y square into dy by dx the whole square is equal to minus 2 into x into y minus 2 into x into y. 1 dy by dx can cancel with its reciprocal 1 over dy by dx. So then we are left with only dy by dx plus this is the reciprocal 1 over dy by dx whole square into this, so that is 1, so plus y square. Okay, so rearranging this one, y square is equal to, take this to the left hand side, then rearrange it, 2 into x into y, dy by dx, plus y square into dy by dx whole square, into dy by dx whole square. Okay, so call this as equation 3. So this is the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories, which is same as the differential equation of the given family of curves. So if I solve this, I get again a similar kind of parabolas as the solution, which is nothing but the orthogonal trajectories of the given family of curves. That means a set of parabolas, they cut themselves at right angles, and therefore the given family of curves are self-orthogonal. Now that means what we have to show that the given family of curves are self-orthogonal, it is enough to show that the differential equation of the given family of curves and differential equation of the orthogonal trajectory are the same. Since which is the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories the sets 2 and 3 are the same. We conclude that the given family of curves are self-orthogonal. So given families of curves means parabolas. Curves means your parabolas. Your family of parabolas. we consider another example. Find the arc of the trapezius. The family of curves. Family of curves. Parabolas. Parabolas. Y squared is equal to 4 into A into X. Again, since there is only one constant involved in this equation, it need not be mentioned. A is to be eliminated, like A is a parameter. Okay. So by default, A is to be eliminated now. The solution for. So consider the given family of curves, parabolas, y squared is equal to 4a. So let me eliminate a by differentiating what's with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. So 2 into y dy by dx is equal to 4 into a into 1. Therefore, a is, so this is 2, therefore, a is y divided by 2 into dy by dx. Now substitute in 1. Substitute in the relation 1. Then y squared is equal to four into x. A is y divided by 2 into dy by dx. So 2 we can cancel. So y squared is equal to 2 into x into y into dy by dx into dy by dx. All this as equation number. So 2 is the differential equation of the given family of curves 1. So this is the differential equation. This is the differential equation of the given family of curves 1. Okay. So in this differential equation, have to replace dy by dx by minus dx by dy. The replace dy by dx by minus dx by dy in the relation 2 into. So therefore, y square is equal to 2 into x into y minus dx by dy. So simplifying, I get y squared is equal to minus 2 into x into y into dx by dy. So this is the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectory, which is the which is the differential equation. Differential equation of the orthogonal trajectory which is the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories. Now call this as 3. Solve the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectory 3. Separating the variables, you can easily, 1y can cancel here, 1y we can cancel. So y is equal to 2x into dx by dy, you can cancel 1y. So solve, separating the variables, we get, there is y here, that means y is equal to minus 2x dx by dy. So let's write here. This is nothing but y is equal to minus 2x into dx by dy. Now separating the variables, we get y dy is equal to minus 2x dx. Now the variables are separated, therefore its solution is integration of each side. So integral of y dy minus 2 into integral x dx plus some constant c. Now integrate this one. So this is y square divided by 2, y square integration of y with respect to y, y square divided by 2 is equal to minus 2 into x square divided by 2 plus some constant c. Or this is y square is equal to minus 2 into x square plus 2 into c, or y square plus 2x square, or y square plus 2 into x square is equal to 2c, or c dash, okay, 2c. So this is the orthogonal trajectories of the given family of parabolas y squared is equal to 4ax, which is the orthogonal trajectory of the given family of curves 1. Okay. So with this I will conclude today's session. I will continue in my next classes. Thank you.